Right. Welcome, everybody, in the room and to the many people on Zoom. My name is Phil Alexander, and I'm delighted to be hosting this concert on behalf of Edinburgh Jewish Cultural Centre as part of Scottish Interfaith Week, and with the much appreciated support of the Fanny and Moray Glassy Foundation, Netherlee and Clarkston Charitable Trust, the National Lottery Awards for All, and the Reid School of Music in the University of Edinburgh, where we are. There's six performers on tonight. We had a very loose brief, which was to create a short set of music or poetry or song inspired by or influenced by the connections between humanity and the environment, and perhaps with a sense of spirituality as well. You might argue that it's quite difficult to have a sense of the connection between humanity and the environment without some idea of the spiritual in there. I'm going to introduce everybody as we go along, and I'm going to kick things off with two pieces by the Argentinian tango composer Astor Piazzolla. He wrote a series of four pieces called Estaciones Porteñas, which is Buenos Aires seasons, each one of those influenced by a different season of the year. We're a bit short for time and the seasons are quite long, so I'm only going to do two of them. And of course, being Scotland, I'm going to skip summer. And I'm also going to skip spring. We're going to hear autumn and winter, which is kind of appropriate for where we are. And I was drawn to these pieces many years ago, partly because they're very beautiful. They're very enjoyably luxurious to play, but also they are part of a long-standing tradition, which we see in classical music and also in a lot of traditional music and in kind of Broadway song and jazz torch songs and things like this, which is a creative urge to make connections between the changing of the seasons and changing and evolving and growing and diminishing human consciousness. And in that sense, I think they speak to a certain sort of deep idea of cyclical time and cyclical rhythms, which is maybe something that we're in certain parts of the world at risk of weakening or losing that connection. So in that sense, I think they're important pieces as well. I hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I'd like to introduce the next performer. I'd like to ask Inge Thomson to come and join us on stage. This is a fantastic gathering of musicians from different places and different traditions. I'm very excited to hear. We also haven't heard what each of us has put together, which is an extra thrill for all of us. I think that Joe will probably see that, and I think he'll probably put them together. Thank you. That's a good point. I think Joe's got that, haven't you? Thank you. Inge is, I'll just introduce Inge very, very quickly. Inge is a multi-instrumentalist, songwriter, singer, composer. She's from Fair Isle, and natural imagery and natural themes and also the sounds of the natural world have often featured in her work. And please put your hands together for Inge Thomson.
Thank you very much. What an absolute pleasure to be out tonight. I'm going to sing you a song first, which was one that was written as a kind of aid to the Fair Isles bid to become marine protected a few years ago. And actually, I'm very happy to say that in 2016, we were awarded our MPA. But this song is... but this song is kind of a hymn to the Kittiwakes, and over the last couple of years, the Kittiwake numbers have actually recovered quite a bit, which is also a very good thing. So this is called The Snowstorm. The sky, a snowstorm of angels deceiving my eye. You've lost it before, something's gone, something's lost, something's broken, something's gone. Something's lost, something's broken. Shape of the glass in the hands of a child, shaken with sea spray. Earful feathers and facts, Mother Nature reacts. In the end we'll have no say. An island of ice with a careful for 20 years or more, we've scrutinized the marks on the graph, the rise and fall of it all. So what are we seeing here? It's just the same snow globe, but the bubble's gone dry. Wait for the bird's response to the sky. An island of ice with a careful gauge for 20 years or more. We've scrutinized the marks on the ground, so we'll pray for the white rocks. Oh, 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 oh. silver return to the sea with our very last gasp. Oh, 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 the air is still. Something's gone, something's lost, something's broken. 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 Thank you very much. And the next number I'm going to sing for you was actually a very strange commission that I received a couple of years ago from an artist called Bill Drummond. The commission was to write a new body of work written in the dead language of Old Norn. So given that there weren't very many existing texts left in Old Norn, this is what I came up with, and it's called Mirka Brodminta.
As it is in heaven, breathe, breathe,
along the sidelines, a beard of trees around the lost chin. Oia Ed Murkidoy, Oia Ed Murkidoy, Oia Ed Murkidoy, Oia Ed Murkidoy. And the island is a dark eye, and the island is a dark eye. Thank you very much. I'll do one more for you. This is a song which I wrote in response to Rachel Carson's book, The Silent Spring, and I know Rowan is going to speak a little to that a bit later on. But the book itself was written in 1962, I think it was, yet it's very apt. And it was quite predictive in its nature, unfortunately. So this is called Silent Spring. And this is going to be my last number. So thank you very much for inviting me, Phil, and thank you to the Jewish Society for hosting. And thank you for all coming and Zooming.
Thanks, Inge. Fantastic. Okay, we have perhaps rather ill-advisedly decided to turn this into a hybrid event, not just in the sense that there's a live stream, but we are also zooming in a couple of performers. And the first one is hopefully going to appear. Well, look, there she is. Wow. This is Sasha Lurje, and she's from Riga, but she lives in Berlin. She's one of the kind of central forces of the Renaissance and revitalization of Yiddish music, and can be found wherever great music, especially great Yiddish music, is to be made. So welcome, Sasha.
Thank you, Phil. It's really lovely to be here. In this strange form, I feel like I'm floating over people and sharing what I can share. I picked a couple of songs to sing for you today. and I want to start with this old song that is also a new song. For those who know something about Yiddish music, you probably all know about Moshe Berigovsky and his wonderful collection of Yiddish tunes and songs. And this is an old tune that comes from that collection, and our friend Sarah Gordon in New York wrote new lyrics to it. And I felt like this is a song that is very fitting for this general idea of this event. The text is based on, very loosely, on one of the songs Jewish people sing for Passover, Echod Mi Yodea, one I know. And normally one that you know is God, but Sarah took it to a different place and made it into a song about the little beauties of life. I know one, and one I can believe in. What can I believe in is that I know things. I believe in the miracle of freckles and the new blossoms on a lonely tree, and a little sparkle from my tear. I believe in sharp pain from the first love, and I believe in blood red from an open plum. And the little bit itchy spaces on a new wound. I know that there are single moments that are single miracles that make life. Ay da 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 da, echad mi yodeo, echad echad mi yodeo. Ay da 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 da, echad mi yodeo. Ay da 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 da, in was kann ich glauben? Echode mi oi deio. Ay da 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 da, ich kann sein am Eimen. Sprenklen und die neue Quäten von an Elten Bäum. Ei, dei, dei, der Finkel von mein Tränen. Ei, 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 ei
gespaltenem Wurm an ihm am Minna, der Beginn, was öffnet klare Augen, euch kann sehen. Die Einzelnen nissen, was schaffen erleben, an ihm, ein Jo, ein Sprenklen und die neue Quäden von an Enten Bäum. Hei, dei, dei, der Winkel von mein Tränen.
This is so wonderful to see audience. I can see you over there. I know you don't see yourself, but I can see you a little bit. thank you. The camera was just moved so that I can see more of the audience, which I really, really appreciate. I'd like to sing you old folk song. I think what I love a lot, it took me such a long time to figure out what folk song I want to sing you, because so many of them have to deal with nature, and nature is just such an important part of Jewish tradition and song. But if you really look at it, it's kind of like any folk song has this connection to nature, to the regularity of living. Very often, singers' feelings are expressed through the change of weather. The passage of time is expressed through seasonal changes. But also, natural powers are so connected to stories and legends in Jewish religious tradition. And this is a song that tells us a story of Jonah the prophet. And for those of you who don't know, I'll give a quick translation because it really just goes through the story. Jonah the prophet was told by God that he has this mission, but he didn't want to do that. So he tried to run away. And in the most powerful way, God came down on him with a forceful storm, and he was on a ship, and of course they had to figure out one of them is causing this natural disaster, and figured out that it's Jonah, and he had to be thrown over the board. And however, in 3 days and three nights, a miracle has happened. A fish that swallowed him spit him out on the ground, healthy and strong. But here is the wonderful trick and turn in this song. The singer says, so you, God, you can do miracles like that? You can take Jonah and put him in a belly of a fish and get him spit out alive. So you can make miracles like this. So this is how you should help me also. You should show me how I should feed my husband so that he's healthy. So with the wishes of joy and health and light irony, this is a song about Jonah the prophet, Jonah Hanovi. Jonah Hanovi ist von Gott entlaufen. Wollt nicht gewollt kein schliches Gehen. Auf dem Schiff hat es ihm getroffen, wenn die Schifffahrt ungeheim hintergehen. Gewalt warf dem Geurlois, wemmend me soll in Jammer einwerfen, Geurlois. mine hanofi minastam. Inter draimis les, hot got bashertan nes, a fish o timos gespigen zirig. Ham die hingesen, wie es is geschen, nis im fin got allein. A zoi sollst du mir wasen, wie mein Mann zu spasen, ob zu hieten sie jene Finnam teut. Dus kennit keiner, nur die Gotteiner, rate wene jene Finnam teut. Dus kennit keiner, nur Gotteiner, ob sie rate, wenn ich euch nenne, wie Name teut. Oder so. Thank you. I have one more song for you, and it's another old new song. The text is a poem by Avrom Lesin, and the music is written by our friend from Brooklyn, New York, Joshua Letsky. It's a song called Bahelferol. Bahelferol is basically, traditionally, a teacher's assistant. So his job would be to go around the village or the shtetl and gather all the children to take them to school, to take them to cheder. And of course, there are multiple amazing stories about it. For instance, in the winter, you can imagine a deep Eastern European winter where there is a lot of snow. He would take children on his shoulders and carry them to school because the snow was taller than the children, I guess. But one of the great powers of how all these children would be gathered and taken to school is with a song. So he would take them and sing with them. And the whole forest would resound with the song and answer with its sounds and trills and patterns, as if the God himself is answering with this great song. All these different creatures and Jukunjaba, frog and bug and little green birds and flowers with little eyes and the brown bear and the cute little rabbits all sing along and take these kids to be educated, smart, and better human beings. So this is a song where I so hope you are also going to join me in this song that makes all the trees and birds and flowers sing along. Ay dai dai yada dai 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 ay dai dai ay dai yada dai 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 ay dai yada dai 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 ay dai yada dai 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 ay dai dai yada dai 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 dai. Sich aber helfer und geht, singt vor sich an ihm stiller Heid. Leitzele geht sich häuf zu häuf, kleib die kleine Kinderlach zu neuf, kleib die kleine Kinderlach zu neuf. Weldeloi, so ne Weldeloi, in a Spiegel, grünem Schein, in a Spiegel von grünem Schein.
ay dai yada dai 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 ay dai dai yada dai 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 ay dai dai ay dai yada dai 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 ay dai yada dai 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 ay dai yada dai 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 ay dai dai yada dai 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 singt mit uns der ganzer Wald und der Geräusche perchschire Schalt Schuck und Schabe grüne Fägelach blimmelach mit schwarze Eglach alter Moch und junge Gräslach bräuner Bär und Rose Hässlach Geht das Schire in Himmeln heuch und mein je heische Meira bo und mein je heische Meira bo Yada dai 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 ay dai dai ay dai yada dai 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 ay dai yada dai 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 ay dai yada dai 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 ay dai dai yada dai 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 everybody ay dai yada dai 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 Yada dai 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 ay dai yada dai 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 ay dai dai yada dai 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 oi tate ay dai yada dai 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 yada dai 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 ay dai yada dai 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 ay dai dai yada dai 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 ay dai Yada dai dai dai, ay dai dai, yada dai dai dai, ay dai dai, yada dai dai dai.
A schönen Dank. Thank you.
Thanks, Sasha. We will see you possibly later on in the show. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, folks, that's half time. Hello, everybody. Welcome back. It was good, wasn't it? That was a good first half. Okay, we're going to have an equally good second half. We're going to begin with our second virtual performer, our second Zoomer. This is Tawona Sithole, who is a Zimbabwean poet and musician and playwright. He's UNESCO artist in residence at the University of Glasgow, and he is co-founder of Seeds of Thought, a non-profit co-op for creativity. Can he hear us? Not very well. He can see us. If you want him to see you, turn around. You see the more or less the light of the projector. We all wave at Tawona. Can you see us, Tawona? Hey.
I can.
Right. Okay. Please welcome Tawona Sithole.
Greetings to you all. Shalom. In my dad's language, we say Hekani to celebrate the gathering. It is wonderful to be here. I should give my appreciation to Phil for making all this happen. And I should also offer my apologies for not being there this evening. It would have been wonderful, but some family adventures have taken over. But it's still great to be here in one form or the other, virtually this time. And I'm going to open by playing. I'm going to show you, this is the mbira. And so this is the music of our ancestors. I just loved listening to Sasha, who I caught there, and this, so happy to be with you all and to share in this. I love this idea of nature being so, you know, valued, because for my own family traditions as well, this is so important. So I am going to play this music that our ancestors have played for a long time, and now I am also continuing that tradition. The music of mbira, which celebrates the earth, because the instrument itself is made from iron keys, and this tree called mvamaropa, which it's a hardwood, which if you nick the tree, it produces a bright red sap, and for our ancestors, they read that as you know, a metaphor that what we do to nature has a consequence. So we, even though we love this music and we want to honor our ancestors, we cannot, for example, in the tradition of the making of these instruments, there are no trees to be cut at all. Either the forest offers us the tree by the tree having, you know, gotten to old age and fallen, or the wind has, you know, blown the tree down, or else if we're feeling a bit urgent about making the instrument, maybe taking a branch off and leaving the tree standing. So I will play for you a song called Nemam Sasa, which is a song that does so many things, but it is mainly a celebratory song. So for being gathered today is a beautiful vision to see from where I am. I wish I was there, but let's celebrate the gathering. So in Nemam Sasa, there is a part where we say, Changamire Simka Mtambe, we're celebrating everyone's majesty. There's no one majestic person amongst us. We are all majestic in our own ways. So Nemam Sasa. Yeah. Thank you so much. I should mention my family, who were so interested in the folklore, the stories, and the music, the poetry, all kind of comes together. And in particular, my grandmothers on both sides of the family, in my tradition, those are the storytellers. We call them Ambuya. We don't actually have a word for storyteller. In both my mom and my dad's language, we call them Mbuya and Gogo, but the grandmothers are the storytellers. So yeah, within the stories, there's so much that goes on, and stories of song, poetry, movement, all that. And I want to share with you, in terms of poetry, when we are first born, if your mom is a Shona speaking person in Zimbabwe, then this is the poem you first hear in your life. And I should just say, by way of translation, the poem, it sets up this drama, the baby's crying and distressed. Where's mom? Where could mom be? And so the poetry is an excuse to talk about the landscape, to describe the beauty of the landscape and describe things that happen on the landscape. Someone is crossing a river, someone is sorting out their grain, laying it on the ruware and all that sort of stuff in there. And in the end, we just come back to return to what we know, that mom is there anyway. So the initial drama was just a child seeking the comfort of Amai. Mwana wangu achema akom, achemera mai wakaenda, wakaenda kwa jigampunga, jigampunga magaka aora, aorera mhiri kwa mngezi, kune banga jena, re kucheka nyama, nyama nyama nde paruare, hei no njiva, ino guru guta, kangwa na msasi, kangwe kari kumba, kano kanga riyo, riyo shabatete, sanga yangu ya wa, yazo nungwa nani, na ambia dende, waze isepi, Murugwezi rukuru no jiwa chambune nenge tenge. Chia, gaka! Ekan. So yes, I'm going to do a poem in English as well, and then another song. I like writing short, very short pieces. So I'll do a very short one and then a slightly longer one. So a short one. I feel the need, but in numbness, I need the feel. Again. That's it. It is the duty of the mind mature to remind the nose not to frown at manure. It is food for the rose. That one's gone as well. Okay, a bit of a longer one. So praise is so important to us, as not just in the poetry and the praise songs, you know, that are, you know, composed for occasions. And, you know, when we see, I love when Sasha was talking about the little miracles of every day. So, and praise poetry as a lifestyle, you know, I think we all recognize, you know, I am, you know, strangers do wonderful things, you know, in our lives if we pay attention, because sometimes you're just walking along, maybe you're going for your train, or as I do regularly, and then someone just smiles or nods or just does a gesture, shares a gesture to show that they are, you know, welcome in your presence, and they are happy in their day. So these things, I pick those up more. And I love that, because sometimes unknowingly people have sort of really energized your day, and you get along on your way. So praise is a very important part of this. So yeah, this is a new piece which I've just almost finished. I will know if it's finished. If I was there, you'd have told me what you think. But yeah, I think it's finished. Let's see. So it's called Praise Poetry. And I mentioned Gwenyambira. Gwenyambira is the musician. When the musician arrives, everything starts really happening. So I mentioned the Gwenyambira in there. And there are bits of Ndawa as well, my dad's language in there. Maybe I'll explain them after. So Praise Poetry. Ekaniwaro Gwenyambira. Time to play. So we get to work, soaking in the abundance until we are soaking in the abundance. Like reeds in rapids, shaken strong by song of the misunderstood, saying send for more firewood, for the proverbial fire would never diminish. Trees moving to rhythm of nyamavuvu in the abundance. Twigs twisting to the rhythm of champupuri in the abundance. The long-awaited rain is pronounced by the words tonodzai pasi changamir. The long-awaited rain is announced by the birds. Kovira, kovira, in and out, chop, 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 chop. Wild ways of witnessing, language worth learning. Mashu machangamire, can't begin to say, won't know where to end, of paschigare, accompanied by humility, surrounded by teachers. Ekanuaro, Sorojena. The artist behind this carving of a poet and my family name is an ancient poem. So how would I represent? How else would I represent than to do by heart? Ekanuaro, Sorojena. It's time to play, so we get to work, absorbing the abundance until we are absorbed in the abundance. Like reeds in rapids shaken strong by song of the misunderstood, saying send for more firewood, for the proverbial fire would never diminish. For the proverbial fire would ever blaze praise poetry. Hey, Candy. Thank you so much. I'm going to squeeze in the shortest story my mom has ever told me, and then I'll play one song. and let others also share what they're sharing. So the shortest story goes like this. One friend invites the other home for a meal. That's the story. But then if you ask who the friends are, the one inviting is Shoshe, the ant, and the one being invited is Elephant, Nzo. So there you are. Something about the strenuousness of hospitality. Okay, here is a song called Gandanga. Gandanga, the spirit of Gandanga is one who is on the fringes. In the folklore, Gandanga is the one who somehow prefers to spend more time in the forest than in the homestead. And whilst this person is normally ridiculed or frowned upon in the homestead, they actually experience many new things that those of the homestead who pride themselves with their polished ways do not experience. So this spirit is very important in creativity, because it's only those who venture outside the comfort zones that who can bring exciting things and new things to us, even language, even words, you know. So Gandanga, in that spirit, those of us who, you know, venture a little bit further than the safety and comfort of what we're used to. And in that spirit, this song, the repertoire is so big of Mbira that even those who are called masters will never master the music, because there's so much of it to learn. So you learn what you can in your time, and each player can put words to the songs they want to do. There are some choruses that are sung as part of the folklore, but you put your own words. So for my brother and I, in our journey, especially moving to Scotland and being welcomed here within the things that interest us, you know, creativity and music and performance, we have just found ourselves within a family. So that facilitated our integration. I guess this is the word that is sort of used a lot, integration, this attempt to integrate that is spoken of. So for us, we look at our journey. Our music is the instruments we have, at least six generations now within the family. So we are on this journey where we are sharing the music in that spirit that it was shared before us, of celebration. And in that respect, we look at the journey as having no set destination, because if you arrive, it means you stop moving. So this is Gandanga.
Vijaya Repano Mambo Vino Kosanava
Vijaya Rebana Mambo Rino Kenyambira. Oh, Tariraibo. Oh, Yagia Yeho. Chambere tedu zobi kamuketa tarira iko harawa ziye mambo zino karandare oh tarira iwa oh tarira iwa patinoba patinoba Patinoba, Panofaba, Chichu, Kamu, Mashiriwe, Panofaba, Chichu, Kamu, Mashiriwe, Dogari,
Tawona Sithole. Wonderful. Okay, don't go anywhere, Tawona, because we might need you a bit later on. Thanks very much. We'll see you soon. Okay, we're going to move on. Next up, we have Rowan Hawitt. Rowan is a PhD candidate here at the University of Edinburgh, but also a musician and performer on the cello and also the sax, which she's going to play for us tonight. She writes and researches about the connection between music and the environment, and as she puts it, she writes from an eco-critical perspective, which I like very much. I think we could all have an eco-critical perspective. It might do us some good. Please welcome Rowan and her partner, Paul Newton-Jackson.
Just doing a bit of untangling. Well, hi everyone. As Phil mentioned, I'm a musician and PhD student here in Edinburgh. And I was particularly delighted when Phil asked me to speak because, as he said, I researched this sort of connection between music and the environment. And particularly, I research how folk musicians are addressing our current climate crisis, focusing mostly on questions of time, so how they're thinking about time. And it's been wonderful as well to hear that there are so many connections with how I'm thinking and how the musicians we've heard so far are thinking. Phil mentioned the idea that maybe we've lost some kind of connection with the cycles and rhythms of our planet. Sasha mentioned that a lot of the folk songs she sings have this also this recurring idea of weather patterns and seasonal change. So it's really brilliant to kind of come and talk a bit more about where I'm coming from with this. So I'll explain in a moment more of what I mean by time in this music. But broadly, as someone who cares deeply about both music and our planet, I'm interested in how music can help us understand the relationships between ourselves, other species, and our environment. And I'm hoping you can help me with this. So I'm going to ask you to do a little thought experiment. Don't worry, there's no audience participation. So could you think of two or three words or phrases which come into your mind when I say the words music and time? Everyone watching at home is, of course, very welcome to join in here. So if you can, notice and remember what music and time makes you think of. So hold that thought, we'll come back to it. In the meantime, I'm going to talk about why we need to think about what we mean by time. The topic of climate and environmental change is saturated with the concept of time. We ask ourselves, why aren't institutions and governments acting in a timely enough manner? How much time is left before ecological disaster? What will our future climate look and feel like? Then there's the timescales of which humans have little comprehension, like the tiny 24-hour lifespan of a mayfly, or the centuries-long lifespan of a Greenland shark. I often wonder what it would be like to live on those timescales and how it would make you see the world differently. So when we're talking about the environment, there are always questions of scale and time. Now, going back to our thought experiment, could you please again think of two or three words or phrases which come into your mind when I say time and environment? These might end up overlapping with the ones you wrote on music and time. They might be completely different. So time and environment, what do you think? We'll come back to these in a few minutes, so just let some of those thoughts percolate. I'm asking you to do this because I think music and the ways in which we think and talk about it has a lot to offer discourses on the environment, particularly around time. When we think of time, a lot of us will picture a clock ticking or think about the passage of years in our own lives. It's tempting to view time as a universal thing, a constant, all-encompassing stream which none of us can change. However, this doesn't tell us much about how time is actually experienced or lived. Nor does it allow for the fact that there are always multiple times that humans and non-humans helped construct. I'd therefore like to talk about time in a way that acknowledges that the actions and lives of different species and the points at which they match up or are mismatched are what helps us create multiple times and temporalities. So I'm going to draw on what eco-feminist philosopher Val Plumwood terms shadow places. These are the places which many humans affect in their everyday lives but aren't aware of or choose to ignore. A good example would be the sites all around the UK at the moment where our sewage is being pumped into the sea, or the Great Pacific Garbage Patch, where so much of our plastic ends up entangled with marine life. These shadow places are places we don't see at the point of consumption, but which are often most detrimentally affected by our actions. I want to draw on Plumwood's ideas to suggest that there are also shadow times, temporalities which often pass us by. Think about the notion of seasons. This concert opened with Phil's fantastic rendition of Piazzolla's Four Seasons. But what actually tells us we're in one season and not the others? It's the rhythms and the times by which more than human species live their lives. So in autumn, for instance, the points at which the leaves change color and fall, or the sound of geese arriving in Scotland to overwinter, are markers of our seasonality. But even the times that these species inhabit are being disrupted by human activity. This was clear in Inge's beautiful song, Silent Spring, which we heard earlier, inspired by the book of the same name by conservationist Rachel Carson. Carson researched the use of synthetic pesticides in the USA, suggesting that they were causing vast declines in bird numbers, hence her prediction of a silent spring, when these species could no longer call. Pesticides such as DDT thinned birds' eggshells, leading them to break prematurely. Here's a shadow time. The relatively recent use of pesticides by humans has deadly repercussions for the life cycles and breeding patterns of bird species. Carson's work and Inge's song bring these times into view and into hearing, illustrating how we are capable of disrupting the temporalities and lives of others. Personally, I never want to experience the shadow time of a silent spring. There are also other times which music can help us notice. We're going to hear Michael sing a ballad about the Chernobyl disaster later on. Nuclear power and warfare, particularly the waste it produces, is probably the most extreme example of shadow times I can think of. What does it mean to use weapons and energy now in the knowledge that the toxic byproduct will be the problem of future generations, human and more than human, thousands of years from now? I recently went on a walk with singer Corinne Polwart to Sycar Point on the East Coast. Sycar Point is a promontory where the geology is exposed such that you can actually see where two geological eras in the rock strata collide. It's an absolutely brilliant place. I really recommend you go. It was here that 18th century geologist James Hutton formulated what became known as deep time, the notion that there are vast geologic timescales which are almost incomprehensible to humans. We think of rocks as static, dependable. Deep time tells us that they're in flux and subject to change as well, albeit on timescales far beyond our ken. When I was at Sycar Point with Corinne, we were looking north, where, just as you're standing on geologic time, you see Torness Nuclear Power Station. We talked about the idea of there being different types of deep time and wondered which would outlast the other, the rocks or the waste generated by our voracious need for energy. Corinne has just released an album with pianist David Milligan. I highly recommend you check it out. One of the tracks is called Sycar Point, and thinking back to that stark view of the power station, the words of the chorus which end the song resonate particularly strongly. Corinne sings, "Tell this time to the ether. Tell this time to the ones who are still to come." In appealing to our accountability to future generations, Corinne's song sheds light on the ways that humans, mostly in the global north, have cast a shadow time which extends far, far beyond our own lives. As we all know, right now over in Glasgow, politicians and policymakers are meeting for COP26. I want to emphasize the 26. The first COP was in March 1995, before I was born. There has been time to make significant changes, but instead, wealthy governments and institutions have only furthered our temporal and ethical disjuncture from other species and the planet we live on. When I listen to those in government, I mostly hear short-termism and anthropocentrism. The thing that gives me hope at the moment is the increasingly loud and inspiring cultural change coming from artists and musicians and also from grassroots protest work. What I find so exciting about music which deals with our planet and those who inhabit it is that it offers a kind of musical time consciousness, uncovering the shadow times and thus throwing the light back onto us humans and the mistakes we're making. Even the vocabulary we use to talk about time often has its origins in musical discourse, rhythm, sequence, cycles, amongst others. Think back to the wee exercise we did earlier. I'd be interested to hear if there was any overlap between the words you thought of for music and time and environment, or if you think the themes from one side might speak to the other. Please do come and talk to me after the concert, as I'd love to hear the different ways in which people are thinking about music, time, and environment. You can also send me an email by Googling my name, and you'll find my university contact details. We've certainly heard this evening how music can give us a time consciousness with ethics at its core. I'd like to conclude by emphasizing that musicians and audiences can help us redesign our temporal and ethical relationships with other beings, our world, and each other. Music is reorienting, It helps us see with more than human eyes and hear with more than human ears. I'm going to ask Paul to come on stage just now, and we're going to play you a short piece that we've come up with based on a melody from the 13th century on the very medieval instruments of saxophone and electric guitar. So far we've heard a few seasons. We've heard autumn and winter from Phil, spring from Inge. So we thought we'd complete the set and have a little bit of, conjure up a little bit of summer in the middle of November. So you may know the tune that this is based on. It's called Summer is a-Coomin' In. As well as mentioning the sounds of other animals, this medieval piece centers on the sound of the cuckoo, often viewed as a herald of summer. Again, here's an example of how our own understanding of seasonal time is intimately entangled with the lives of other species. Yet even the most archetypal sound of the cuckoo is at risk. Since the 1980s, cuckoo numbers have dropped by 65% in the UK. This is largely due to anthropogenic climate change, which has resulted in changes in the timing of breeding for the other birds in whose nests the cuckoo lays its eggs. Another shadow time. In this piece, we've tried to use different musical lines to emphasize different speeds and timescales, which, as I'm sure you've gathered by now, is something I think music's very good at doing. So do listen out for the call of the cuckoo when we're playing, and remember that it is a much rarer sound now than when Summer is a-Coomin' In was penned 800 years ago. So we don't want to bring the mood down, so I want to just finish by saying that places like this, gatherings together, in which we celebrate the gathering, as Tawona so rightly said, are places where cultural change happens. So thank you so much to Phil and to the Edinburgh Jewish Society for organizing. I hope you enjoy. This is called Summer is Coming.
Rowan Hawitt and Paul Newton-Jackson. Wonderful, thank you. We just have time for our final performer. And this is someone who'll be familiar to some of you, and some of you out there in Zoom land as well. It's a great pleasure. I think this is his return to the stage, the live stage, first time since pandemic, which is wonderful. I'm delighted to be helping that one along. So this is Michael Alpert. He's one of the kind of driving forces of the Yiddish and klezmer renaissance from the 1970s onwards. He's a US National Endowment Fellow. He has ethnomusicological fieldwork, which is currently in the Library of Congress. And he is a kind of voracious collector of traditions, Yiddish and otherwise, from around the world. And I think he is a wonderful end to this concert. Please welcome Michael Alpert.
Hi, thank you, Phil, for that wonderful and most concise of introductions. Hello, everyone, in here and out in Zoom land, as Phil mentioned. I love the fact, I don't know if some of you that are familiar with the Netherlands or Belgium may know that there is actually a place called Zoomland. It's Zoomland in Dutch. It's the area along the river Zoom, which is spelled Z-O-O-M, and it's, I guess, the original Zoomland. Make of that what you will. I loved what, here, I have to put on an accordion, so it's kind of like, you know, can you zip me up in the back there? I'll do that first. I loved what Tawona said about people being on the fringes and outside of the comfort zone. I think we all have various experiences of that. In my case, as you hear, I'm originally North American, and I'm still originally North American. And I'm originally from the Pacific Coast and grew up partly in New England, and after living 35 years in Manhattan, I now reside in the East Nuuk of Fife, in a village by the sea, which is also on the fringes. And as a matter of fact, to resonate with what Rowan just said, we look out our windows at the Torness nuclear power station. So in addition to the great, beautiful panorama of the North Sea and the Firth of Forth, we have Torness to remind us of, among other things, remind us of shadow time. It seems that it might have moved a bit, yeah. No, I wanted to move it just away from me a little bit. Which brings me to the next song. Thanks, Phil. Which is a song I wrote 35 years ago, in 1986, within a few weeks of learning of the nuclear catastrophe at Chernobyl. And it is, I wrote it in Yiddish, which is a language I grew up speaking. Inspired particularly by the fact that though much of the world had never heard of Chernobyl before April 1986, for those of us familiar, or anyone familiar with the certain aspects of the East European Jewish milieu, Chernobyl was a very well-known name, besides just being one of the very many Shtetlach or partly or predominantly Jewish towns throughout Eastern Europe. It was the center of a very important and influential Hasidic dynasty, the dynasty representing the East European Jewish version of Jewish mystical tradition, and a Hasidic dynasty that particularly focused on images of fire and of light. And so the irony to me when I first heard, you know, that there was a meltdown in a nuclear power station in Chernobyl was like, how ironic, you know, that these are worlds colliding, the world of the shtetl and Jewish Eastern Europe with nuclear catastrophe. So this is a ballad. The melody is from a type of old-time Ukrainian Jewish ballads. And these are my words about Chernobyl, among other things. The song asks what this place has to do with us, and at that, since I wrote it in Yiddish, I mean, the focus was, the us involved was the fact that on the graves of our ancestors in this place that has already seen, not only for Jews, so much travail, a new angel of death is dancing.
Thank you. Thanks, everyone. And thank you to Inge Thomson for not only for your wonderful music and sentiments, but for allowing me to use this great accordion too.
He had a guitar.
So, my dad died 41 years ago, and he was already not so young, but not so old. Actually, if he were alive today, he'd be 115 years old. So he was born back at the beginning of the 20th century in Lithuania, which at the time was part of the Tsarist Empire. And came to the U.S. Just before World War I and lived the rest of his life there. And so this song took me 38 years to write. I started writing it, talk about slow work habits and so forth. No, I started writing it a couple of weeks after my father died, and then thought I can't really write a song that sums him up adequately at this point, and put it aside for 38 years. And then a couple years ago, a friend heard my efforts to begin it and suggested it inspired me to finish the song. So the song talks about, it's both in English and in Yiddish, it talks about times that my father and I, as so much of my family did, spent in the natural world and with various creatures that surround us. And it speaks about both time and places and creatures from our time when I was young in California, also in New England, where I spent a great deal of time, and with my father in a place up in New Hampshire, an island in a lake, actually. And it was a place my family recreated Lithuania in many respects in the U.S. And then finally, it also, not just finally, but interwoven in there is the world of the sea, the sky, and many creatures where I live in Scotland today, in the East Nuke, so. Called Heron on the Wing. My father was an immigrant from far across the sea. He came from so far away to end his journey here at the edge of a field by a line of maple trees, glowing red and yellow in the autumn of the year. Born in an empire at the very edge of time, in a small town in the forest, he came into this world. Wheels of war were turning, fires of change were burning. He sailed away into a distant land. Sie wird von Jeden noch ein lang Weg den Jeden. Mir haben kam aus dem und sie sein in Schinito. Die Zeit lebt wie ein Hose weg in tiefen Wald rein. In Schkie, wo man da auf die Felder die dunklen die Kumpelo. Hoi, nimm dir mit dein Hack und Säg, dein Tatschkalle, Fuchlo gerät.
Hep dir mi di stila lahti po jene di zwei Ich hum dir schein an kegen nor ich geh dir noch nit noch Auf dein weißen Weg den stil in die Schnee In the murmur of the maple, in the sighing of the pines, in the wail of the midnight loon where the glowing moon hangs low, in the ripple of the silent fish that stir the depths below, your fire is in me everywhere I go. When the ice goes out in April, you pull the boat up in the cove. Hear the thunder quake on the summer's lake in the August sunset glow. And when December's icy hand lays bare the wooded grove, your tracks are in the deep and driven snow. Ой, тише едешь, дальше будешь, так отльется, так и пьется, с кем поведешься, того и наберешься. Ой, тише едешь, дальше будешь, так отльется, так и пьется, старость не радость, сегодня треба выпить. Kennst dich nur auf mir verlassen, deine Meile sein Gitterei und mit Ehrlichkeit sich führen auf der Welt. Now for all the roads we traveled and the ones we didn't go, for all the tears these many years, this twilight song I sing. And when the fog of autumn lies upon the rocks below, my heart is like a heron on the wing. Na 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 na.
Thank you. Some of you might have heard that there's some. Sorry, I missed that. Or should we talk about it later? So I'd like to finish, I guess, this wonderful concert, which has been just amazing to both be part of. As Phil mentioned, it's my first concert Since March of 2020, actually the last one I did was with Sasha and her wonderful partner in life and music, Craig Udelman, here in Edinburgh in the middle of March 2020. It's just been wonderful to be with all of you here and to share the stage with so many remarkable people in this remarkable country and society we live in here in Scotland, too. And so I'd like to finish with a song that's, it's a traditional Hasidic song, and what it does is go through in the order of the Jewish alphabet, the Hebrew alphabet, as many such songs do. Traditionally, it says if you don't have all kinds of different virtues, that many of them universal virtues, along with any material wealth you have in this world, what's the point of living here in this world or doing anything or any of our striving in the world? But I tweaked the words a little bit in more or less Yiddish to be about environmentalism and what needs to happen and some of what needs to happen up the tracks in Glasgow. In general. So it has a chorus that I hope you'll all join in with, and the chorus goes like this. I lie, 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 lie. I lie, 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 lie.
Come on!
long ago, when the past was the present and the present was the future, they played the drum song. Some heard the words, some saw it coming. Those who saw it becoming, they played the drum song. And so time went on as time goes on, till some heard about it. Those who remembered from time to time, they played the drum song. That was the time. This is the time. That was the life. This is the life. Old memories sweeping the lane. Fresh winds sweeping in the rain. Farmer's hand sweeping in the grain. Playing the drum song.
Nishtas a vaid gaven. Oi golas, golas, vi lang bistu. Shchine hok doyshe. Weit gewen Volder Goles nicht so lang gewen. Ai dai 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 ai dai ai dai.
Inge Thomson, Paul Newton-Jackson, Rowan Hawitt, Michael Alpert, Phil Alexander, Tawona, Sithole, Sasha, Lurje. Thank you very much. And a special thank you to Matt Elliott, who has put this whole audiovisual extravaganza together. Thank you, Matt.
Yes. Thank you, Edinburgh Cultural Center, Phil, everybody. Let's do it one more time. Aye, 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 aye.